tape 9 in the interview with Norbert Bikales. Who is this a picture of?
This picture is my mother's family. It was taken in 1932, in the summer of 1932, during the visit that I made to Borislav, which was then in Poland. And it shows from left to right my mother.
Her name?
My mother, excuse me. My mother, Bertha. Her brother, Bertha Bikales. My uncle, Moishe Bander, who did not survive the war, but he, people knew him during the war, and he almost survived the war, but died just before liberation. My grandfather, Meyer, the rabbi in Borislav.
And his last name?
Meyer Bander. Harry Bander is next, my uncle in America, who had come in especially for that same visit. And my aunt, whose unfortunate name I do not recall at this moment. She is the sister of my mother.
How did you get this picture?
This picture was in the possession of Harry Bander. And he allowed me to make a copy of it. This is not the original, this is a copy.
Who is this a picture of?
This is a picture of my class in Berlin Neukölln, at the public school number 21-23. That's Volksschule, public school. It shows my class. I'm the only Jew in the class. It shows my teacher also, Herr Wendt, Mr. Wendt. And I'm the kid there whose face is hidden. There's a kid with a sweater in front and a tie, and I'm right behind him, the face half hidden.
And your name?
I'm Norbert Bikales.
And what year was this taken?
This was taken during an excursion to a park in Berlin called Kreuzberg. And this was 1937. So I was 8 years old at the time.
And how did you get this picture?
I've had this in my possession all along. This was a class picture that was taken, and I've just kept it. It just survived.
It went with you to France Switzerland?
Well, what happened was, that I didn't tell that on the tape, but this Mademoiselle Metzger at UGIF in Chambéry kept my pictures when I went to Switzerland over the mountains, and she gave them back to me after the war. She hid those pictures while she herself was in danger, and gave them back to me after the war. That's how all of my family pictures survived, the ones that stayed with me.
Who's this a picture of?
Well, this is one of a few pictures of myself, Norbert Bikales, and my parents, my father, Solomon, and my mother, Bertha, in Berlin in May 1939, just before our final separation. It was taken with a camera that we had bought, brand new camera, very expensive camera, and somebody else took that picture. I don't know who that was. One of two pictures taken that day that survived.
And how did you, is this the picture you referred to on the train?
Yes. Yes, this is the picture that I could not get myself to tear. It's got a little tear in the corner. But one of the things that worried me about this picture is that you could see the garbage cans in the back, including that little black box on the left side, which is a recycling can. In Germany, you started recycling early already. And because you got ready for war. And I was afraid that the Germans looking at this would recognize that this was this was German. But it did survive, fortunately. And this is truly one of a few pictures I have with my parents, and very precious memory.
Who's this a picture of?
This picture is of the children from Berlin who were in the Kindertransport to France and was taken in Cannes in 1939. And it shows only a small group of them, all the children who were approximately the same age as I and Norbert Bikales. I was 10 at the time, the others are more or less the same age. The woman in the back is Raymond Sauviac, who whom I and others have nominated for, to be a just among the nations, because it turns out that afterwards she saved several Jews, including a whole Jewish family that she hid in a cemetery.
And which one are you?
I'm there toward in the second row toward the middle with a sweater that has a zipper. That's me there. In front, there are two children who are the two Gossels brothers that I've referred to in my story. And among the other children, there are Werner Goldschmidt and Gerhard Glass, who were with me in not only in Cassie, but later both in the orphanage, the Rothschild orphanage, and in Chaban.
And how did you get this picture?
This picture actually is a Xerox copy. Unfortunately, it's not the original. It's a Xerox copy of something that Peter Gossels had in his possession. I've also seen the original. Raymond Sauviac, the woman in the back, has the original also.
What is this?
We're looking here at the last sign of life from my parents. At the top, you see the envelope of a telegram that I received in Cassie. And I received it the day, either on my birthday or the day after my birthday in 1940. So my birthday is on the 7th of January, 1940. So this came at that time. And the message is from my parents. You can see the postmark there from Cassie with a date. It says it's the 8th of January, actually. And it came from Lvov, which is where my parents were at the time. They had been after the deportation from Germany. And it says, we send you congratulations, new félicitons. Congratulations, because it's my birthday. And it's signed by Bikales and Klein. Klein is the family of my aunt and my uncle, who had also been deported from Berlin, and then and then some address which I could not make out. I wrote to it later, but I could not. But it says Lvov, Ukraine. It was occupied by the. It was in the part of Poland that after September 39 was occupied by the Russians. By the way, not only was I happy to get this, that showing that they had survived the war in the first part of the war, the attack on Poland, but that they found themselves not in the German zone, but in the Russian zone, where clearly it was safer than under the Nazis.
And how is it that you didn't tear this up on the train?
Well, I just couldn't. I just couldn't. This is one of those documents that, you know, I never got to. I think I stopped after a while. I tore up letters, but somehow this one, I guess, be so thin, so inconspicuous. It's very thin, fragile paper. I guess I didn't get to it, fortunately.
I noticed your name there is spelled with a Y.
Yeah, because this is a transliteration from the Ukrainian, because they had to send this, and I'm sure, in Ukrainian.
Who is this a picture of?
Well, that's myself, Norbert Bikales, and the occasion for the photograph was an application for a visa to come to the United States in 1941, when the Quakers came to Chaban in France, and so we needed passport photographs and visa application. This was taken. They hung a sheet there as a background and took a photograph. It was wartime. I was 12 years old.
What is this a picture of?
This is a postcard, actually, and it's a postcard of the Chateau de Chaban, the place where I was between 1941 and 1943. It shows the building in much better condition than it's now, or was then, for that matter. It's a very glamorous picture. The building was in bad condition, and is in even worse condition now. It's abandoned.
What is this a picture of?
Well, this is a picture of the secondary school in Saint-Pierre-de-Fursac, which is close to Chabanne in central France. And the people you see here, most of them are actually villagers, boys and girls from the village of Chabanne and the surrounding neighborhood. Some of the boys and girls are from the Chateau de Chabanne, those Jewish children who were being kept there by the Osée and that I've described. I myself am sitting in the front row, the third one from the left, in the zippered sweater. On both sides of me are two boys who also were from the Chabanne, from the home. They're not local people. We've had reunions there, and I've met some of these local people since, and they've been very, very warm and generous.
When was this picture taken?
This picture was taken, I would say, the fall of 1942, because in the summer of 42, I finished elementary school and received my diploma, and then started the secondary school in Saint-Pierre-de-Fursac.
And how did you get this picture?
This picture actually is a Xerox copy of a document that was made in connection with a reunion that was held in Chabanne in 1996. So it's a recent one, and it appeared recently, but a photograph, of course, is from 1942.
Who is this a picture of?
Well, this is a group of youngsters in Geneva, the Homme de la Forêt, in the home run by the Osée. These are all Jewish children who have escaped from France. And in fact, this photograph is a group of kids, all of whom were in Chabanne before. So not only were they friends from Geneva, but they're friends from Chabanne also. And a couple of them actually came from Berlin with me.
Do you know their names of the people?
Girard Alexandre is in the back, in the middle. That little guy in the back, he lives in Paris. On the right side, on the front row, is Walter Herzig. Now he probably pronounces it Herzig. He lives in Cincinnati. The guy next to him is David Hirsch. He lives in Buenos Aires. Oh, there's several people here. I myself am on the front row. I, Norbert Bikales, I'm on the front row in the T-shirt on the left side.
And this was taken when?
This must have been taken in 1946, just before I came to America, either 1945 or 46.
Who's this a picture of?
Well, this is a picture of my birthday present. This is my birthday, January 7th, 1946, my 17th birthday. And I'm there with my brother, who had survived the war in Poland. And somebody took a picture of us. We met at the border between Austria and Switzerland.
And your brother's name?
My brother's name is Richard.
Bikales.
Bikales, and he is 8 years older than I am.
And you're Norbert.
And I'm Norbert.
Bikales.
Norbert Bikales, that's right. And that's us, two very happy young men, having found each other after the war.
Who is this a picture of?
That's a picture of myself, Norbert Bikales, on my arrival in the United States on the 7th of July, 1946. The building you see in the back is LaGuardia Airport. I had arrived by plane on KLM. And this is the Marine Terminal, which is still in existence, but looks a little different now.
What is this a picture of?
Well, this is a picture of myself, Norbert Bikales, marrying Gerda Brzezinski. And we're cutting the wedding cake, the proverbial wedding cake.
And when was this taken?
This was taken on the 28th of April, 1951. Neither Gerda nor I had graduated from college, but that was it. That was our wedding.
And where was this taken?
This was in New York City. We got married in New York City. We had a very small wedding. We couldn't afford much more. but it was a very joyous one. You can see we don't look too unhappy at the occasion. By the way, the picture was taken by this good friend of my brother's, whom he knew in Vienna, whom I had mentioned before, at Jerry Walter.
Who's this a picture of?
This is a picture, the two people in front, let's just talk about that, is first to the left is the president of Israel, Professor Katzir, Ephraim Katzir, and myself, Norbert Bikales. I was attending a scientific meeting in Israel at the time, I think this was 1973. I gave a talk there, and it turns out that President Katzir, in whose presidential house this was taken, is himself a scientist. In fact, he's a colleague of mine, and he's in a very similar field as I am, and one of my books has been dedicated to his brother. I presented him with a copy of that. His brother was murdered by terrorists in Israel.
Who's this a picture of?
These are two very, very wonderful people. On the left side is my wife's mother, Blanche. At the time, she was called Paczynski, but because she married a second time to the man on the right, Abe Paczynski. My mother-in-law, unfortunately, no longer is alive, but Abe still lives, and we go to see him periodically. He's 91 years old at this point. This was a studio picture taken on, I think, the anniversary.
What year would that have been?
I guess this was about 10 years ago, so let's say
1988.
About.
And where was it taken?
It was taken in Fort Lauderdale, Florida, where they lived.
Who's this a picture of?
Well, again, these are two wonderful people. On the right side is my son, Eddie Edward. And on the left side is Ellen, at the time Ellen Butler. This was the day they decided to get married. So they're sitting in the middle of West End Avenue in Manhattan, a huge snowstorm. This is January 6, 1996, when there was an enormous snowstorm. And they're having a cocktail, a drink, to celebrate the occasion. And they're dressed rather scantily, I would say, for the occasion. The wind was blowing, as you could see. This is the picture that they sent with a wedding invitation that followed.
And your son's last name was Bikales?
Yes.
Or is Bikales?
Is, and Ellen Butler now calls herself Ellen Bikales.
Who's this a picture of?
Well, this is a picture of part of my family, a very important part, and you can see that the occasion was rather festive, the way everyone is dressed. It was my grandson, Benjamin Solon's bar mitzvah. You can see him on the right side, standing between his parents, my daughter Peggy, and her husband Bob. The little kid on the left side is my other grandchild, Jonathan. He's 3 years younger than Benjamin, so he was 10 years at the time. And then the big girl in the back is no longer a teenager. She's already a young woman. She's Bob's first child from a previous marriage.
And their last name?
She is also Solon, and she's Katie.
Who's this a picture of?
Well, it's obviously a picture of myself, Norbert Bikales, but two very precious people to me, my two grandchildren. The bigger one is Benjamin Solon, and the younger one is Jonathan Solon. This was taken, I believe, in 1993, and it's during the summer. We are visiting California. My daughter's family moved to California for 1 year, so I can place this exactly. They moved to Irvine, California, and this was taken on a hill overlooking Irvine, right above their house. And I love that picture. We're wind-blown there, And the kids are sort of hugging me. I think it's one of my favorite pictures I have in my office.